Everything in nature boils down to chemistry. When most kids were thinking what they want to do as an adult, I said I wanted to be a chemist. The colors, the smells, the fire, that's what really brings you in. All chemical processes can be broken down into quantum physics. Here at Intel, we're harnessing chemistry and quantum computing to push the limits of processing power. The entire computer industry is built on bits of information. Transistors in conventional computing operate in binary states, zero or one. If it was a coin, heads or tails. Now take that coin and spin it. While that coin is spinning, it is neither heads nor tails, but both at the same time. That spinning coin is like a working qubit, the basic unit of quantum computing. Two coins, that's four possible states. 300 spinning coins would represent more states than there are atoms in the universe. Qubits operate at very low temperatures. So we use a special enclosure called a dilution refrigerator that is roughly 250 times colder than outer space. And when you open it up, it looks something like a steampunk chandelier. Intel's manufacturing and architectural expertise will actually lead to a more scalable system. You would be able to complete a sequence of calculations exponentially faster than you could ever hope to do with a classical supercomputer. New materials for energy, financial optimization, new medicines for various diseases. We're about 10 years away from a commercially viable quantum system. There are many pieces to the puzzle of building a quantum computer. I think about group chemistry a lot. We have material scientists, transistor experts, RF design engineers. I really love assembling a team and watching them come together to tackle a really hard problem. And I get to be part of that. It all starts with chemistry.